Hello friends, welcome back again. Today we are going to discuss about assertion reason type questions. It come in almost all exam, especially of UGC NET exam as well. It is one of the most scoring topic in UGC. But in many times, this kind of questions will confuse you a lot. However, we are going to discuss simple trick. If you apply that trick on these questions, it will be very easy. And you can get the answer within few seconds. Assertion reason type questions has these five different options given. First two options are saying that both assertion and reason are true. But in first option, reason is the correct explanation of the assertion. And in the second case, reason is not correct explanation of A. Third and fourth option, either of A or R are true and other is false. The fifth option says that both are false. So a reasonably well prepared student can answer assertion reason type questions in a matter of few seconds. So we are going to discuss what are the steps to answer these questions. First, you need to read both sentence assertion and reason to see if they are correct or incorrect. If both A and R are correct, then the answer comes in these two first options. Then it is little bit confusing how to select option A or option B. The easier way to solve in that case is to write like this. Assertion statement is true because reason statement is true. If that makes sense to you, then option 1 is correct. Otherwise, option 2 is correct. Now, if you are able to find an incorrect statement, then you have automatically knocked out the first two options. Because first two options are saying that both are correct. Now, the answer falls in these last three options. If option 5 is not given, then answer will be there in these two options. So, you have to find one incorrect statement, either A or R, you will get answer very easily. Now, if option 5 is also given, you need to look the correctness of other statement as well. If both are incorrect, then fifth option is the answer. Now, let's look some real questions from previous year question papers and solve this applying our techniques. So, this is a question from UGC NET previous paper. The assertion says that the problem of environmental sustainability are difficult to resolve. That is true. Our understanding how environment works and how different human choices affect environment is inadequate. That is also true. So our answer comes in the first two options because both statements are correct. Now let's apply our earlier rule that assertion is true because reason is true. Let's read these questions like that. The problems of environmental sustainability are difficult to resolve because our understanding how environment works and how different human choices affect environment is inadequate. This makes sense to us. Then option 1 is the correct answer. So this is the simple way to solve this assertion reason type questions. Otherwise, it will be very time consuming. Let's look at another question. Here assertion says that sustainable development is a critical to well-being of human society. That's true. The reason says that environmentally sound policies don't harm environment or deplete the natural resources. That is also true. So the answer comes in the first two options. Now let's read this assertion reason as we did earlier, like assertion is true because reason is true. Sustainable development is critical to well-being of human society because environmentally sound policies don't harm environment or deplete the natural resources. That reason doesn't make sense. So the answer will be second options because both A and R are correct, but R is not the correct explanation of A. Now let's look another example. Your assertion says that all teaching should aim at ensuring learning. That's true. The reason says all learning results from teaching is false, because some learnings are coming without teaching as well. So we are easily knocking out the first two options, and the answer comes in the third and fourth options, because one of the statement is incorrect. So the first statement is correct here. So the third option will be our answer. Now let us look at another example. The assertion says here, the initial message to student in the classroom by a teacher need not to be critical to establish interaction later. It is critical. So the assertion is false. By reading the first assertion itself, we are knocking out the first two options, because it says that both are correct. Now the answer lies in these two options. So if assertion is false, then the option 4 is the answer. So if you apply this technique, the answer is a matter of few seconds. Enjoy this technique and best of luck.